All right, here we are. We're going to talk today about how to talk to your clients. So one of the big things that that comes up when I get on the phone with folks is they feel like they just can't connect with their clients. Like they're telling them what they can do, and you know, the conversation seems to just not be getting anywhere. And oftentimes the conclusion of the conversation is the client either rejects the proposal or takes the proposal but never gets back about whether or not they want to move forward. Or if it's a conversation over the phone, then you know the client will oftentimes say they'll call you back after they have a chance to think things through, and then of course they never call back, or whatever it may be. The end result is a disconnect. You don't end up winning the project. You don't end up working with the client, and then of course you feel really frustrated because you're sitting there knowing that you have what it takes to be able to deliver the kind of project that they're looking for. You have the skills. You know that you can do this stuff, but on the other hand, you can't connect with the client. And generally speaking, the only way to move forward with that is to try to connect with folks in a way with that just kind of automatically gets them to work with you because of something other than the value that you're offering. Like maybe you lower your price, or maybe you're the only one around. And so you end up getting the project in spite of the way that you're talking to the clients, not because of the way that you're talking to your clients. So the thing I wanted to talk to you today is like, so why is that happening? What can you do about it? How do you recognize whether or not that's actually happening? And so that's what we're going to be diving into today. So the big picture is, oftentimes WordPress developers talk a lot about SEO and content marketing and blogging and WordPress maintenance plans and updating plugins, you know, especially with regard to trying to get recurring revenue coming in. You know, the WordPress maintenance plan is like a big thing. And if not that, oftentimes they'll also throw in some things like, you know, get discounted hours. Like if you buy 5 hours per month, you know, you'll do it at a discounted rate. But of course, there's nothing really specific about what you're going to do during those hours. It's just that you do something. You know, the people are pre-purchasing some sort of work from you, some sort of time commitment for you. And then, of course, people sort of, you know, just get disconnected from that. They don't really feel inspired by that, and it's not something that really drives people towards making any kind of decision to start working with you. And so the way that I thought I might be able to draw that out a little bit to kind of illuminate this for you to see if this is something that you're doing, whether it be on your website, on your phone calls with clients, during client meetings, in your proposals, you know, wherever it is that you're interacting with clients, wherever it is you're communicating with clients. Is this something that's going on? And you know, and can you spot this in the way that you're interacting with folks? And so I thought that maybe an analogy might be pretty good. So I remember when my wife and I were getting married, we were planning out the wedding, and we were trying to figure out, you know, what kind of music do we want at the wedding? You know, are we gonna hire a band? And if so, what band is it gonna be? Or maybe do we want a DJ? And what kind of music is gonna be played? And so we were really kind of thinking that through. And so you know, so imagine if like I was a band, like so imagine that I run a band of I play music and we do gigs at places, and you're the one trying to, you know, run, you know, hire somebody for a wedding. And so you call me up on the phone, I answer the phone, we start talking, you know, things seem to be going pretty well. And then as the conversation moves on, I begin to you know, ask you some questions about what it is that you're looking for. And but rather than saying things like, you know, what kind of music do you like, or you know, what are the ages of the people that are going to be at the event, you know, to try to, you know, cater to the different kinds of songs that different age groups might like, or you know, do you have any favorite songs, do you have any songs that you want to play during the entrance, you know, whatever it might be, how long is the event? Instead of asking questions like that that actually matter in terms of getting the event going and making sure that you're actually providing what people need. Rather than that, what if I started asking questions like, do you prefer mahogany, rosewood, or maple wood on the top in your acoustic guitars? You know, what do you think sounds better out of that? Or do you prefer light or medium or heavy gauge strings? Or do you even prefer nylon strings over steel strings? Or you know, what is your favorite time signature? And you know, what kind of tempo do you want? And can you tell that to me in beats per minute? And so I start asking you questions like that. And then on top of that, then I begin to, you know, sort of underscore my authority in the field of playing music. And I start saying things like, I regularly work with the metronome to make sure that my rhythm is constantly improving and staying steady, and I always keep my guitars in rooms with at least 50% humidity to prevent cracking and warping, and so they always sound awesome because of that. And all the members of my band are like deeply familiar with like natural and harmonic and you know, pentatonic scales. You know, everybody knows all the theory, you know, whatever that might be. And so as you can see, like I'm talking about all this stuff, and you can tell that I know what I'm doing. You know, I know about the different kinds of tones of wood when it comes to guitars. I know about the strings. I know about scales. I know about, you know, rhythm and metronomes and how to keep the instruments running well. You know, I know about all of that stuff, but it doesn't help you determine at all whether or not, or maybe the teeniest bit, because maybe you feel like I'm experienced because I'm saying these things, but it doesn't help you decide whether or not you want to work with me, whether you want to hire my band to play at your wedding, right? And so the issue here is, like, when you kind of take it out of the world of WordPress and out of the internet and sort of put it into a different industry, then you can sort of see, like, kind of right off the bat, that these kind of questions, these kind of statements, you know, the kind of stuff that you would talk about to underscore your authority and your confidence in your field, it doesn't make any sense. Nobody would ever have a conversation like that. It's one of those things that's sort of ridiculous. But when you get into the world of WordPress and the internet and online marketing and online stuff in general, for whatever reason, it seems like conversations really gravitate down this road. And so what my encouragement is for today is, you know, try not to do that, because what ends up happening is, like, these are the kinds of things, like in the context of the music analogy, if I was actually talking to other fellow musicians, like, this is the kind of stuff, like, I am a guitar. I play the guitar. That's, I mean, the reason I know all this stuff is I played the guitar since I was like 20 years, 30 years, whatever, for a long time. And so so I know about the tonal qualities of wood and the different kinds of gauges of strings and nylon strings versus steel strings and the different kinds of scales and the time signatures and tempo. I know about all of that stuff, and I talk about that kind of stuff with other people that play the guitar and are in bands. And this is the kind of stuff that is interesting to talk about, and it literally does make a difference. Like, different kinds of woods make different sounds. It's a different kind of a thing, but it's the kind of conversation you have with other musicians. But when it comes to the internet and WordPress, oftentimes WordPress developers take this kind of, you know, internal conversations, you know, like, what WordPress plugins do you use? What themes do you use? Where do you host? How do you keep things secure? What do you do if you get hacked? What if malware gets in there? How do you keep servers running? You know, whatever it might be, you know, all of those different, or WordPress maintenance plans, updating plugins, differentiating between WordPress core and WordPress plugins. You know, all of these types of things are things that WordPress developers say all the time. They say things like, you know, I'll give you a WordPress maintenance plan, and in that plan, I'm going to make sure the WordPress core is updated, and then we'll, you know, update the plugins too, and, you know, whatever it might be. And, like, the person that you're talking to, they don't know the difference between core versus plugins or any of that stuff. And it's one of these things that really drives a distinct disconnect into the conversation. And so the other side of the coin is, like, perhaps from your perspective as a WordPress developer, you're saying all the things that actually matter. Now, you're saying things that people really need to know or at least do with regard to their website. And so you're feeling like, hey, I'm giving you all of this great information and all this stuff that you can be doing, but you're not hearing it. You're not doing it. And so I think that's where a really big part of the frustration comes in. And so if you're having conversations like this with your clients, then, you know, maybe this is one of those things that we can do something about. We can talk about that and figure out how to get over that. So I guess what I'm trying to say is, if you feel like this is the kind of thing that you're struggling with, and you're thinking to yourself right now, okay, well, yeah, maybe, you know, you look at your website, or maybe you think back to the last client meeting you had, or the last, you know, prospect phone call that you had, or maybe you're thinking through what you're going to put on a proposal, or something along those lines, and you're thinking, oh yeah, you know what, you know, I really am actually, you know, talking about the caliber of string and the tonal qualities of wood, you know, that kind of stuff. You know, I'm talking about SEO and digital marketing and content marketing and WordPress plugins and core and updates and security and all of those types of things that your client only cares about because those are things that you need to actually build the site. They don't actually care about knowing about the details or anything else like that. And so you're wondering to yourself, okay, well, what do I actually say instead? Like, what's the alternative? What do you say to not be having this problem. And that's what that's one of those things that we can that can help you figure out. And there, you know, there's kind of three components to it. One is you want to get clarity on who your ideal audience is. Like, who are you trying to speak to? Like, what is your ideal client look like? And what kind of issues might they be facing? And then on top of that, you want to focus down on like what market are they in? Like, what industry are they in? And then on top of that, you want to talk to your clients about like what matters to them in that industry. And so if that's the kind of stuff you want to figure out, because you don't really know who your target market is, or you know what kind of clients you're looking for out of that market, or you don't really know what kinds of things that people in those industries are worried about or whatever, then let's get on the phone and we'll talk about that and figure that out. And determine, like, you know, maybe you're thinking about, you know, trying to go into a couple of different industries, or maybe it's not really industry based at all, but more a particular type of service that you want to offer that might apply to a bunch of different industries. So all of these are types of things that you might want to think through in order to be able to articulate your message in a way that really connects with the people you're trying to talk to. So if that's one of those things that you're struggling with and you want some help on that, and you want to just kind of, you know, throw around some ideas and think out, you know, think through some issues, and really get some clarity on what you're really focusing on, then schedule a call with me, a free one, and we'll talk about it. And you can do that at doublestack.net/call, and that will enable you to find my schedule. My personal schedule will be online, and then you can pick a time that works for you, and then we'll get on the phone and we'll talk. You'll see a little form right afterwards that has a couple of questions about your link to your website, so I can check it out beforehand, and just, you know, who you normally work with, you know, just some background information about who you are and what you do, so that when we get on the phone, it'll be really valuable and we can spend like 45 minutes really going through this stuff together. Oh, look, it's Rebecca. Hey, Rebecca. I just noticed the comment. I've got the camera and the screen are separated. And so let's see, with clients with the, that's a great conversation starter that you have there. So, you know, conversations about working with your clients about what they want the website to do and things like that. That's definitely better than jumping into SEO, but I definitely think we can even dive deeper than that. So in fact, I think I might even be talking to Rebecca here in the near future. So that'll be an exciting conversation to have too. I'm looking forward to it. So if that's the kind of thing that you guys want to talk to me about, then hop on over to doublestack.net, schedule a call, and we'll talk it through. And if you have any other questions that come up because of this, go ahead and put that in the comments below, and I'll be keeping an eye on this post throughout the week, and we'll reply to those things. And if you want to stay connected to this by way of email too, like say you can't make it to the all the Facebook Lives, I will actually send out an email after each one, and you can get a video replay of that. So if that's something that's interesting to you, you can sign up for the DoubleStack newsletter. So go over to doublestack.net and you'll see a place to sign up for the newsletter there. And so the email list or whatever. And that will, and then I'll send out an email link to the video replays so that you can always get all of these videos and tips and tutorials and so forth as we move forward. So awesome. So that's what I got for today. And if there's any other questions, again, like you have, go ahead and leave those in the comments. If you want to talk, head over to doublestack.net/call. And I look forward to talking to you. And we'll be doing this again on Thursday. I've got another one of these sessions planned for Thursday. So high five. Whoop. And I look forward to talking to you guys again soon.